This Guitar Interactive Bass Review is brought to you by Bass Direct. Find out more at bassdirect.co.uk.
Back down in the basement with a cool little chap here. This is the Höfner violin bass from the Greenline. Now, first of all, what's interesting about this instrument is the Greenline in itself. And what this actually means is for over 20 years, Höfner have been very green in terms of creating, building basses. So, whereas previous models of this instrument have had plastic fixtures and fittings and non-recyclables on it, this, the H500, is the first bass to go into the Höfner line where absolutely everything on it, as much as possible, is recyclable. So, let's get in up at the headstock end. I'm going to go through each of the fixtures and fittings and talk about the instrument a little more closely. Up at the headstock end, we have four nice small tuning keys. I'm going to fit the bass over so we can have a closer look at those. Gone are the plastic key ends and have been replaced with metal because they are recyclable. We can melt those down and create some more tuning keys. Or whatever it might be, actually. And we can see on the back of the neck already, whilst we're here, we have an absolutely gorgeous piece of flame maple, and the pinstripe down the back is now walnut. We're used to seeing rosewood in there, and of course, with the various site agreements, rosewood is being a bit of a problem to export. So we've got some nice walnut on this instrument. Do you know what, whilst we're here, let's go all the way down the back of the neck and onto the body as well. Lovely piece of flame maple, some really lovely figuring on this. The plastic cap here is now being replaced with walnut. And we've got this beautiful piece of flame maple on the back as well. It's a lovely satin finish, so no glossy finish here, which I think really, really does look elegant. Flipping the bass over, the underside first. Again, walnut binding all the way around. And let's go back around the other way as well. Like so. And there's flame maple again for the sides there. Really, really sweet. Now we'll come back to the front of the body in a moment. So we're going to go like zoom back up to the headstock and then come down the fretboard. So over we go, like so. And we have a really beautiful walnut face to the headstock. And we've got a laser cut logo here with a wood insert as well, which I think is really, really attractive. It's amazing to think that, you know, an instrument, the plan behind it was to remove any non-recyclables, but I think it's actually made the bass that much nicer for it. Even the nut, look at this. It's actually a three-piece nut. So it gives us a lovely pinstripe through the middle. Onto the fretboard, zero fret. I've always been a big fan of zero frets on instruments. And the fretboard, much like I was mentioning about the pinstripe down the back of the neck, is now walnut as well. Höfner have done lots and lots of testing between good old rosewood that we're so familiar with and then walnut, and decided that actually, tonally, not a lot in it. And it's kind of like it's another good wood to work with, good and hard wearing. And again, I just think it looks really, really nice with the maple. Down the 22 fret fingerboard. Being a downsized instrument, and this is where I must admit I'm struggling a little bit, but I will get used to it if I'm given enough time on this bass, is the neck is really, really tiny. The string spacing is really close. I mean, I'm going to take a guess at maybe 14 millimeters at the bridge. I'm not sure. I'd have to just check that and see if I can put that in the write-up for you. But there's some really, really nice touches here. I mean, even the kind of like the you know, the dot markers are just really, really tasteful coming down, like so. Down onto the body, let's have a look at this. I'm going to tilt it up so you can see a bit of an angle on it. The pick guard has been replaced with walnut again. Really lovely. Pick guard, pickup surrounds, instead of being, say, black or white plastic, look at this. I'd like to see this on more instruments. Very, very lovely indeed. So wood here. The pickups on this particular instrument are the H513B models, and there's two of those. Pickup right up against the fretboard. I like that. There's a nice little low end coming from this. We'll hear that in just a moment. And the bridge pickup here. The bridge itself, if I remember rightly, it used to be ebony. It's now a walnut piece as well. And we've got the sort of the base part here as well. A metal frame for the actual bridge assembly here as well. And well, let's face it, if we've got walnut for your fixtures and fittings, then the knobs are going to have to be walnut as well. And I think I'm going to just turn the base upwards. It's a little kind of hat shape. And they're really, really comfortable, you know, when you're winding them with your little finger, for example. And that just feels really, really comfortable. And it's a nice little touch on there. So I think the instrument itself, even before you plug it in, really does look the part. And it's just a shame that sometimes we're so used to seeing so much plastic on a guitar, which this has kind of changed my mind somewhat. Really lovely. There we go. Well, we've been looking at it. Let's have a little listen to it. So in my opening section, I had the tone control all the way open and both pickups on full. So we have volume, and master tone. So volume for the front pickup, volume for the bridge pickup, and then a master tone. Playing with the tone control before I started recording, I was really pleased with, actually it's very subtle. It only seems to take the very top end off, but leaves that lovely woody tone intact. Now for monitoring, we're going through an absolutely beautiful EA stack, and actually it so happens that the cabinet on this actually matches this bass, which looks really, really great together. So it's a very, very clean system that we're using, a very sort of hi-fi sort of response. And the two seem to marry quite nicely. We are miking and DI-ing the amplifier as well. Okay then, so let's wind the back pickup down. This is just the front pickup on its own. I'm going for the plectrum again, and I don't know, there's something quite funny that I'm actually using an Andy James plectrum here. Andy's obviously known for playing guitar really fast, and I'm going to be playing this little violin bass really slowly. Okay, here we go then. Now, if I put that back pickup back in again, this is how it sounds. And then if I turn the front pickup down, then I'm going to get that nice percussive edge to the back pickup. And the two blended together, you get a nice mixture. And I found that actually on the controls, I could get that almost 60-40 kind of effect, where it kind of like, I get a bit more favor of the back pickup. So let's dial that in, let's see where that is. I think it's about there. Yeah, it is. So I can blend, and there's a nice little point on the dial where I get a little mix where I can start feeding in one pickup over another. Both on, I'm going to turn the tone control all the way down, and I'm going to have a little listen to that, and I'll do some finger style for you as well in just a moment. And it sounds kind of cool, actually. There's something really smooth about the tone, but it's still got bags of character to it. It doesn't sound like a P bass. It doesn't sound like a jazz bass. I'm loving it. Let's get the plectrum out of the way. Bit of fingerstyle. I'm going to start adding a bit of that top end back in. That's about halfway around the dial. Here we go. Cool, excellent. Now, as I said before, I've got pretty massive hands, and getting used to this string spacing, well, I'm gonna wanna spend a bit more time on it, but I can also see the advantages with the strings being close together. It feels awkward at the moment, but my positioning between strings is so much closer than I feel like I can get there more quickly. I don't expect to use this for metal or djent or anything like that, but I could see that there's a closer spacing would actually be useful for some really faster passages when you've gotten used to it. But that aside, what a cool instrument it is. Absolutely brilliant. I think I'm going to have a lot of fun with this, but I think at some point I've got to put it back in the case. Speaking of which, I've got a beautiful instrument here, and it deserves to be put in a really nice case. So it comes with a really lovely fitted case. It's got a nice padded interior to it. And actually, also with the instrument, because you want to know a bit about actually how it's built, is the instrument actually comes with a booklet full of details. And here it is. We've got this really cool booklet. There's a certificate of authenticity, and there's information about actually who made the instrument, some nice photographs in there as well, and some lots of extra details, which I think is a really nice touch, and of course a cleaning cloth that comes with it. So, a really nice case. Some information about the instrument, and also the bass itself. I think this makes for a really, really lovely package. So there we go, rounding up then, this is the Höfner Violin bass from the Greenline.